the Bowl in Atlanta have been playing the crap out of it. When I travel, I do this thing. Every time I rent a car, it takes me a solid 15 minutes to do all the things I need to do to get settled into a rental car before I realize what they had already been playing on that radio station, like whatever station was already pre-programmed in that car. I was in LA last year, and which is home to me, but I just wanted to get out of the rental center, find out where my friends were, get to the 405, and then like I finally got to the radio. But you know how you passively listen, you don't know you're listening, but it's seeping into you and infecting you? Well, it took about 15 minutes. By the time I got on the highway, I was like, what have I been listening to? Turns out it was the pop station I grew up listening to there in LA. They played 3 songs in a row. It might as well have been the same song. It was a dude talking about sleeping with a girl. And I thought, okay. Yeah, that song works, we get it. But there has to be a sweet twist to that song, right? So this is where it got weird. I started thinking about my parents. Stop it, it's not that weird, let me explain. My parents have been married 37 years. My dad says, well, my mom's, right? 37 years, y'all give it up. My dad still says, like, it's weird for him to sleep in their bed when mom's gone for the weekend, whether it's a women's retreat or whatever, and I thought, that doesn't have to be specific to marriages. We've all been in that dating relationship where you get used to the goodnight text message or phone call, and then when you can't get it, you freak out. So, we won't sleep without you, and again, thanks to the Bowl for playing. Thank you guys so much. Have fun tonight. Y'all got it, come on. Wide awake, ain't no good night, yeah. well.